India, the women protest by setting themselves on fire? I tell you, next time the kids are screaming for ice cream and pop, I may just douse myself in kerosene. I use that as a threat to my kids all the time, so it's no wonder they're so screwed up. That's one of the tough things about being a mom, not ruining their lives with guilt. As a matter of fact, I don't let my kids watch cartoons or slasher flicks.
Really?
That Knife After Dark movie may be number one in the box office, but my kids certainly ain't gonna see it. If you don't raise your kids right, they end up being...
Special. She made me wear a bonnet as a child, and when I demanded to go to school naked, she was fine with it. After social services moved me, she would still write to me. I still...
Also, whatever it is in Germany.
I know, but I lie a lot. I've got a lot of personal issues. Look at me. Please, Maurice, I need a hug.
There's another example of immorality in this city. Public showing of affection. People think we want to see them making out and carrying on. I understand your hormones rage like a wild animal, and you want to ravage one another like there's no tomorrow. But you have to ignore what your body is telling you and work for a higher calling, like construction. We're building a statue, and we need your help. Call me now.
You know, pretty soon you won't be able to tell who's a human and who's an android. Why, the corporation is working on it right now. I know, I read about it. I tell my kids not to kiss other kids at school. It might be an android. Suck your brains out. You must have seen the miniseries event on television. I read it in a book. We've got to stop looking at the stars, all this science fiction, and focus on the family. Now, if... There, and leave us in peace. And that's a fact.
What's a fact?
I'm sorry, Maurice, but I have to tell you, I moved to Florida to bring my kids up the American way in a theme park. And that's just the kind of person I am.
You see, the Alaskans are lunatics, plain and simple. They eat whales and snow, and they sleep in the freezer. Who wants to eat snow every day? Oh, I tried to help. I sent a helicopter with copies of my book, but they burned them in a pile for heat. If the people of Alaska choose to live there, let them. But don't come crying when you're tired of eating penguin and it snows 18 feet a day.
Yes, but don't you think it's important...
I think it's very important to listen to me, young man. That's what makes the state of Florida great. Rather than help improve weather, they are, people nationwide abandon their hometowns, come down here, and shove their beliefs down everyone else's throat. That's the American way, always has been. We should send some pictures of Florida to those people in Alaska. I tell you, they'd throw down that bear pelt, saddle up the sled dogs, and get pulled all the way to Vice City. And I should know, I'm from Mars.
No, you're not.
Mars, Alabama. I founded 3 colleges there.
The problem with Alaska is that people don't get naked. If you can't work on your car, or play the cello, or use sharp knives in your birthday suit, then what's the point of living?
Well, it is a bit cold there. People put on clothes when it's cold. We evolved without a warm covering of hair.
That's a lie, sir. We come from the great meteor of fruit.
Clothes are a habit, like shaving and taking out the trash. As soon as you stop, you realize what a prisoner you were to society and the twisted state of morality. People think that nudists are immoral. Well, we're not. And go to breakfast, clothed in nothing but a smile.
What kind of people are there in your weirdo commune?
Single people, families, elderly couples, teachers, politicians, and especially truck drivers. Truck drivers understand what it's like to be by yourself for days on end, with nothing but country music on the radio, and a stick in your hand, shifting gears over and over. Truckers realize there's nothing to be ashamed of on the open road. Get naked and beat it on down the line. You've never seen a sense of community and morality like a nudist colony. We share everything. The cooking, cleaning, wives. A shared sense of what is...
Tommy, Paolo here, to Pastor Amico. Paul. I don't want any fake label clothes.
Very funny, mate, but you know I don't touch bent gear. No, I was just calling to see if I could get a part in one of your movies. Back in England, I did a lot of blue stuff, mate. I'm packing more heat than you, my son.
Paul, thanks for the offer. I'll bear that in mind.
Seriously, don't forget about me. That's all I've done for you.
That's what I'm trying to forget about.
She could have given more than that.
Yes, mean bitch. I hope she dies an agonizing death.
Absolutely, Michelle. And remember, if you want us to wish you well, dig deep and dig soon.
That's right. At any moment, conservatives could vote to end our funding and place a fast food restaurant where our studios are. See, there are some people that think everything has to make money. It doesn't. That's why you should give now.
Correct. Next week is Environmental Week, sponsored by MyBatsu and the Vice City Power Corporation. And next month, we're celebrating Proust's influence on Vice City in association with the Degenitron. But for now, let's return to pressing issues. Remember, VCPR is an advertising-free zone, much like the moon or Times Square.
Welcome back. The show is Pressing Issues. The subject is morality. I'm Maurice Chavez. Let's carry on pressing the issue. And soccer riots and arrived in the Americas in the late 15th century, the subject soon turned to morality. You see, Europeans wanted to colonize America, so they had somebody to make fun of. The pilgrims left England for the religious freedom in Holland, where they visited coffee. To liven up the trip, they set sail for the New World, which they heard had a magnificent roller coaster. Once they got here, they were very hungry, having been on a ship for 65 days. So they ate for 3 days straight. Thanksgiving quickly became an annual custom. America was founded by people who wanted a place where they could tell other people how to live. And I'm a history major. But do we have the right? The question, is it moral to celebrate Thanksgiving, a holiday that is clearly about gluttony, annoying relatives, and awful casserole?
And at my weekly meeting, my congregation has a potluck. You see, a casserole is a lot like life, Maurice, and that's the basis of my philosophy. If you put a bunch of leftovers from the fridge in a pan and bake it, somebody'll probably eat it. It's like my book. You believe in your favorite sports team, then they get massacred. You believe in gravity, then it turns upside down on you. You love...
You'll never find us. You can't stop us because we're underground. Get it right now. Got a big shout out to Sir Leslie.
Mr. Vassetti? Hey, you bought the old print works?
Yeah, my old man used to work on these. I used to spend the evenings with him cleaning the rollers. I was gonna follow him in his trade, but I lived a different life.
You planning on selling the old machinery? Breaking it down?
I'm thinking we might print something. A newspaper, a magazine.
Oh, crap, Sonny. Low-grade crap. I've always fancied printing money. It ain't too hard. You know, I've been doing it on a small scale for years.
Really?
Sure, but we need some good quality plates. Of course, there's a counterfeiting syndicate already operating in Florida.
A syndicate?
Yeah, well, just rumors is all I've heard.
I know a man who's good with rumors.
Out of you, man. That's your loss, mate, innit?
All right, me old China. How's hanging?
What do you know about counterfeiting?
Oh, I'm fine, Paul. How about you?
Come here.
Oh, all right. You're obviously a busy man. All I know about Dodgy Reddy's is to try and supply the plates.
Fuck. You know,
they've got a shipping company down the docks. The boss man would know when the plates are coming in next.
Thanks, Paul.
What's the matter with you, you maniac? Give me another drink, lively.
Take a quick break to listen to some commercials, and then we'll return with another top record for your listening pleasure.
Italian loafers without socks? Deconstructed linen suit? Something missing?
Complete the look.
With a flesh-toned sleeveless t-shirt, and Vice City's one-stop shop for people who dress for success.
Wow, you look like